La da 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 da. John Bosch was a husband, a father of two, a grandfather of four, and a great-grandfather of three, but most importantly, a World War II veteran. He was born on April 6, 1926. He then graduated high school in 1944. And then 2 weeks later, was drafted into the 147th Field Artillery, or as he knew it as, the Bushmasters. John was attached to the 158th Infantry Regimental Combat Team, who was sent from Milwaukee to Fort Sill for basic training. Then, for more basic training, he was sent from Fort Sill, Oklahoma to Papua New Guinea. From New Guinea, John and the other soldiers were shipped to the island of Luzon in the Philippines, and then made two beachhead landings, one in Batangas and one in Legazpi. As they were preparing to invade Japan, John and the other soldiers were told 75% of them would not return home. But as John said, "I never thought we'd lose." Two weeks later, the American troops had bombed Japan and the war was finally over. John was sent to occupy Japan, and after 7 months, he was able to come home as a sergeant of the U.S. Army. A veteran doesn't just have to be the experiences that happened overseas. Many veterans want to tell their stories and their memories. They just need an audience. According to John Bosch, it took over 69 years for someone to simply ask him, "How was it for an 18-year-old boy to be sent off to war?" It's such a simple question, yet no one's ever asked him. So I decided to sit down with him and hear his story. How did you feel after it took 69 years for someone to ask you about your service?
Gee, I was just introduced to this man, Mark Graves, that I met through a friend of his daughter. And he said to me, "Could I ask you a question?" He said, "What did it feel like for a young man, 18 years old, to go to war?" And I was so stunned by the question, I had to think a little bit before I could answer him. But it brought back real big memories of what we went through and what we saw and what we learned. And being that young, I felt that we had to do what we had to do. And I never was afraid that I thought that we would lose the war. And we were equipped with good equipment and good leadership and good camaraderie with all the fellows, all the soldiers we were in combat with.
What moment do you best recall about your service and why?
Well, after our two invasions, we liberated the Legazpi and the Batangas, We came back to rest camp and they were preparing us to go invade Japan, northern part of Japan. And at this big gathering, the captain up, or the general up there was talking to us, telling us what was going on. And he said to us, if we invade the northern part of Japan, about 75% of us wouldn't come home. And that's all you could hear was nothing. There was a big silence. And 2 weeks later, I think it was, they dropped the bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and the war was over. And then we were getting ready to go to Japan, to occupy Japan. And we were sent up to Utsunomiya to liberate the town and airstrip we took over. And after that was done, we went back down to Yokohama, and I was put into office ordnance, doing stencils for the Army, and we were getting ready to go home. I got home on points that we had occurred that built up for overseas, and I think it was 32 or 34. And then I was sent home at the end of April. We were shipped home on a ship. And on the way home, I was had asked by an artist from New York for the USO. He did a pencil sketch of me, and he said, we put that in the paper where the city you lived in. I lived in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And they sent a picture back to me, and the journal had my picture put in a newspaper, and it said, John Bosch is now out of the Army. So that was my only thing, came home all by myself.
Since you returned, were you always willing to tell your memories and stories?
Yes, I was willing to talk about it if somebody asked. And after we went on the honor flight, and after the honor flight, we got to meet all these other veterans, and everybody talked about one of their experiences or one of their adventures they had when they were overseas or wherever they were fighting. And after the honor flight, I had privilege of being asked to go for some book signings and some fundraisers for the Stars and Stripes honor flight. And we talked about the people that veterans that I met, and they were too, that people didn't talk about your experiences, but I always said there should be, take time to listen. There's veterans out there that would like to talk about it. There's veterans out there that don't like to talk about it. And there's veterans out there that want to talk about it and nobody will listen. And they all have stories to tell regardless of what they did in the service, if they were behind the desk or if they were on the front lines fighting with a tank or a gun and occupying some country to free the people that were hostages during the war. So I would like to say one more time, just take time to listen, and I think everybody will learn what all these veterans went through. And I think they would all be glad to tell you a story and take the time. So, God bless America. When you heard what I told you.